beef goulash coming up.
That's right.
The next recipe.
Thank you. I wish I had you to help me at home. I get on a lot quicker. There we are. Now, beef goulash is a dish from Hungary, in fact, and it's a delicious one, something I like a bit further over in Switzerland. I've had the goulash soup, and I think it's the paprika-y rich flavour that I enjoy. I've already started to fry onions for this dish. You first of all take an ounce of lard, and you fry onions, which I've got in here. You fry the onions until they're just slightly coloured, and then you tip them from the frying pan into the casserole that you're going to cook them in, and then in the same fat that's left in the pan here, Judy, I'm going to brown the meat.
And what sort of meat are you using? Is it?
I'm using
1.5 pounds
of stewing steak, and this is chuck, which is a good stewing steak. You could use, if you wish, something like shin, but it would take longer to cook. Yeah. I'm always a bit wary of giving lengths of time for cooking stews because it just depends on the cut of meat that you're using.
Yeah. And you've got sort of what you say your normal sort of inch cubes of meat sort of cut up.
That's right, and I've cut off any gristle or fat. And I'm allowing these days, because everything's gone up, a pound of meat for 4 people. So this is 1.5 pounds, which is plenty for 6 people. Mm. And particularly if you put vegetables in with a casserole, it'll spin it out.
And that's just to seal the juices in, isn't
that's
it?
That's right, yeah. Yes. Mm. Now, I won't be doing this for quite the length of time that it should have frying. It should be really a little bit longer. And then I'm going to add to it, just turn it a little bit more. You can see immediately it's becoming dark brown on the outside.
But obviously you do regularly turn it, because otherwise it would stick.
And another, if you've by any chance got the oven on, you can always do this process so you don't get any spitting in the oven, if you wish.
But again, turn it.
Move it round. Once, yes. Mm. So into the casserole, on top of the pound of fried onions, 1.5 pounds of steak, chuck steak. There we are. Now that really wants to be turned just a little bit more. Mm. There we are. Turn that plate off while I remember. And then to the paprika part, you want to add a tablespoonful of paprika. Now you'll notice I'm buying it in rather a tatty bag. I've brought it in the tatty bag so that you can see and be reminded that it is much cheaper to buy things like paprika from a chemist. Mm. Or this was 8p for 2 ounces, much better than buying it in fancy jars.
Yes, much cheaper. I didn't realise you could get it from them.
Yes, well, I did. Mm. I just saw it. In fact, this was in a supermarket, and I thought, how much better buy? Mm. And then crumble on top a stock cube and pour on a pint of water and then salt. Now, I normally say a teaspoonful of salt per pound of flour. Now, a stock cube is quite salty, so I'm only putting 1 teaspoonful. And then lots
with your pound and a half of meat. Yes,
with the pound and a half of meat. Mm. So that's process one. Put that back in its little place. And then put the lid on, bring it to the boil, and let that simmer until the meat is tender. And that will be, for chuck steak, about 1.5 hours. Longer if you're using a cheaper cut of meat. Mm. And you can do that either on the stove or in the oven. And I've got one here that I've already been cooking. I'm going to move it over to this plate nearer to me.
And in the oven, I think it's what, 350 in gas mark four?
Yes,
for an hour and a half.
That's right. Now there we've got one that's just simmering. Mm. And that is the same casserole that's just been cooked for a little bit longer. Mm. And I'm going to add the thickening to this. And I'm going to add tablespoonful of flour, like this, and two tablespoonfuls of flour. It's a good thing I corrected myself. And then tomato puree, 2 tablespoonfuls.
What's that level ones? That splodge.
Roughly.
It's revolting, isn't it?
I'm just going to put a little bit more because it is difficult.
There we are.
Blend that together. And then, just like when you're making custard, you put a little bit of the hot liquid to this. It is a different way of doing it. And then take some of the hot liquid like this. Mm. There we are. And that's just like making custard, otherwise it'll go in a little bit lumpy if you don't. And you can stand over the pot and do it.
Mm. And that'll thicken presumably fairly quickly in these sort of things, won't
it? It's a lovely solid pan.
Mm.
And that will
retains the heat well.
And then that, just stir that until it's all thickened. You may at this stage have to check the seasoning to see it's quite all right. There we are. Now you can see that's thickened already.
Mm.
And that's rather a nice, a gorgeous colour, isn't it? Lovely and rich.
Lovely smell too.
And then the traditional topping is a little sour cream.
Again, is it to give it a bite, or is it just that
it gives it a nice sourness on the top.
Mm.
There we are.
And you can put an extra blob on once you've served that.
That's
presumably.
Right. Stir it in, and then as you do each plateful, a nice little swirl, and then it looks rather professional and nice.
Very good indeed.